DigiPlus earmarking as much as 2 billion pesos for CapEx this year to sustain its growth momentum and ramp up its digital offerings. The listed digital entertainment company, which is behind Bingo Plus and Peria Games, says more than half of that budget will go to technological upgrades, including cybersecurity. DigiPlus recently launched Color Game, which uses the traditional Filipino carnival games as a setting. It also launched Bingo Plus Poker and Tong Its Plus, which allows users to play the card game without wagering real money. DigiPlus, one of 2023's top performing stocks, recorded a net 4.1 billion pesos of profit last year. That's up nearly 600% year-on-year, driven by the steady growth of its digital retail segment. Small borrowers are expected to benefit from a new credit line facility that AsiaLink Finance secured from Taiwan's Cathay United Bank. The online lending company says it has secured a fresh 300 million peso credit line from Cathay United after earlier securing a line from two other Taiwanese banks, CTBC Bank and Yuan Tai Savings Bank. It says the money will help it grow its customer base and allow it to reach more individual lenders and small and medium enterprises with little to no access to traditional sources of funding. Now, last year, it expanded its loan footprint into the fast-growing auto market for brand new and used trucks for logistics. In 2023, AsiaLink disbursed over 11 billion in loans and ended the year with close to 27,000 new borrowers. The Philippine Customs Bureau beat its collections target for March. Customs collected 75.4 billion pesos, surpassing its 72.9 billion target by over 3%. However, March's collection is still 6% lower year-on-year. For the first quarter, the agency collected 220 billion. That's bigger than the 211 billion it planned to collect. This is also higher than last year's collection of 214 billion pesos. The BOC attributes this to its strict monitoring and collection of deferred payment of government imports for the increase in collections. The Bureau of Internal Revenue confiscates smuggled vape products with an estimated total tax liability of 151.1 million pesos from three different warehouses in Manila and Rizal. Now, that is over 64,000 units of vape products seized, including the brand Flava, which the Trade Department already banned for sale. The agency has been prioritizing the enforcement of excise taxes against excisable goods, such as that of vape products. Just this February, the BIR won a tax evasion case against those behind the Tapfog brand with an estimated civil liability of 1.2 billion pesos. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has created two new special economic zones in Pasig City and Cavite. In his proclamations, Marcos designated several parcels of land with an aggregate of over 124,000 square meters in Ugong, Pasig City to create an information technology park, which will be known as Arcovia City. Of course, this, for those who are familiar, this is within the Mega World Township project, Arcovia City. Now, aside from this, parcels of land in Tanza, Cavite will also become part of the Metrocas Industrial Estate Special Economic Zone with an area of around 400,000 square meters. Marcos issued the two proclamations under the Special Economic Zone Act of 1995 and upon the recommendation of the Board of Directors of the Philippine Economic Zone Authority. Under the administration's five-year Philippine Development Plan, ecozones will play a vital role due to its ability to accelerate economic growth and attract investments. The Philippine National Railway is seeking more funds from the national government. It says the additional money will be used to provide bus fare subsidies to passengers affected by the five-year suspension of its train services, which was done to make way for the construction of the North-South Commuter Railway. The suspension displaced some 20,000 daily commuters, forcing them to take buses instead. But passengers have been complaining taking a bus is more expensive and causes delays in their travel.